Welcome back. In this video, we are going to see how the files are organized. We call it as file organization, and we use a different technique called indexing. This is a method by which we can store the files for easy access and retrieval. So let us see in detail. So file organization. When I say the file organization, we mean to say like how the files are logically arranged, not physically. So normally, when we say how the files are arranged, we always think how the files are arranged physical layout. But we are not worried about how physically they look, but we concentrate on how the files can be arranged logically. So let us see what is the advantage for this. Why we need to arrange the files logically? One is which is going to give you rapid access to one or more records. You can access very easily, rapid access. Second one is insertion and deletion can be done without disrupting the speed of accessing records. Without any disturbances, you can insert or update or even delete one or more records. This is a second advantage. And third one is which is going to give you efficient storage of records, which is going to give you more efficient way of giving it. And the last point says which is going to give you which is going to ensure you the data integrity. So these are the four advantages which logical file organization is going to give you. So let me repeat. So one is rapid access. Second one is insertion, deletion, and updation can be done, little more, faster way, and efficient way of storage. And the last one is data integrity. So let us see how the files are arranged sequentially. So normally, what happened if it is a sequential file organization, the files are arranged the way they are entered, the way they are coming. But the problem with this is sequential files can be read only in sequential way, because we have stored this in a sequential way. So we can read also in a sequential way. You can see on the diagram. So in the top, the files are coming, record 0, record 1, record 3. So end of the files. So the reading also should be done in a sequential way. You can see that. So record n minus 1, then record n minus 2, then record n minus 3, then I plus 1, I. Record 1 and record 0, beginning of the file. This is the way it is arrived, and this is the way, this is the way which is getting stored in the system. So the thing is, as I told, the files can be read only sequentially, starting with the first record in the file. There is no other way to read from this. Next is relative file organization. So this is not sequential way. This is a relative file organization where you can find the address of ith record with the base address, provided every file is of fixed length. So normally, relative file organization is used for the files which is having a fixed length, and which is going to give or you can get the address of ith record with the base address plus I minus 1 into record length. Record length is going to be a fixed one. You can look at here, relative record numbers will be given, and what is record stored in the memory, what is the record stored for each record numbers, which is going to give you, or which is going to be in the form of a relative file organization. So let me make it clear. This is good, or this happens only for the files which has got fixed length. And this is a formula. Address of the ith record will be given based on record length, base address. So which is nothing but base address plus I minus 1 into record length. They will give you the address of ith record. Next is indexed sequential file organization. So this is again quite interesting. We can see every record will be numbered sequentially, normally start from one, as you could see on the diagram. So we start from 1 to n, and for every record number, which is going to give you the address of the record. For index record number 1, what is address of the record? So if you look at the first one, the address of the record is going to be some 765, where the record is stored. So if the files are stored in this fashion, we call it as index sequential file organization. Again, please remember, this is an indexed one. Again, this is sequential and index. So where we have a number for every record, and in this number, address of the every record is stored. Next is indexing. So normally this is based on access type, access time, insertion time, and delete time. Indexing is different from the organization. Let me repeat, this is based on few factors, and the factors are going to be the access time. This is access time, access type, insertion time, and deletion time. There are two kinds of indices. One is ordered indices, other one is hash indices. So ordered indices are stored based on one or more key values. So if it is ordered one, we are going to use some kind of value. We call it as the key value. So in the next slide, we are going to see how it is. And hash indices, indices are based on value generated by a function called hash function. We are going to apply a function called hash function. So please remember, there are two kinds of indices. One is a sequential one, other one is hash one. And for sequential or ordered one, we use something called key values. And for hash indices, we use hash functions. Hash functions we have seen already in the previous slide. Next is dense and sparse indices. So dense indices stores address of every record, which is going to store address of every record. So look at the first one, which is a dense record, where you can find which are stored address of every record. Record number 10, 20, everything 60 is stored. And see, record which is having pointer to record 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. But if you take a sparse index, what happened is which are stored the address of only some of the record in the file, only few records. Look at this. Record numbers, we have only 10, 30, 60. But when it comes to the actual record, we have record number 10, then 20, we have 30. And we have 30, 40, 50, 60. So, which is going to reduce the record numbers in the first. So let me make it clear. Dense index table stores address of every record. So this is the index table. The first one is index table, which is going to store the address of every record. But if you take sparse one, index table stores address of only some of the record. The next is multi-level indices. Again, it's very interesting. Normally, this is used for very large or millions of records. So for such kind of records, it will not be advisable to use or store address of every record. So in this case, we are going to use multi-level indices. A simple indexing techniques will not be sufficient for this. So we have to use multi-level indices. You can see here, record number 10 to 50, 500 is here. Again, under 10, what are the from 10 to 60 in one category, and under 250, which is 250 range, is in other category, and for 500 again. Another three categories. So in the first one, we are storing only few records. So this is known as multi-level indices. The final record is stored over here. And the last one is B-tree one. B-tree one is similar to the multi-level. You can see that this is like a tree where, based on the indices. See, first is start from A to I, then A to C, D to F, G to I is segregated. Again, here it is J to R. So from J to L, M to O, P to R is segregated. S to Z, again, this is bifurcated.